Be strong and get healthy. Stretch. Feel great about yourself and have some fun. It's time for you. Fitness is the key to your future. Don't get locked out. Take the challenge. Commit to be fit. Welcome to Spring Training on Commit to Be Fit. I'm Susie Smith, and today's show is about movement, and we are going to move. So while I'm talking, I want you to get a comfortable pair of shoes, and I brought a couple things with me today. Grab a couple paper plates. If you have small weights, go ahead and grab those, some water, and I brought a yoga strap with me today, but you can actually use a man's tie. So if you have a tie at home, that would be good. This is just to help us later on in the show with stretching. So get your shoes, and we're also going to talk today about the components of fitness: cardio, strength, flexibility, and balance, in that order. We're going to talk about that, and we're going to work out together. And I want to show you just how easy it is to put a program together at home so that you can work out without any hassle. And do you know that the average adult spends 90% of their leisure time actually sitting? And what happens to your body when you sit for long periods of time? Well, first of all, it's totally devastating to your health. It actively promotes several chronic diseases such as type 2 diabetes, obesity, and actually dozens more of different diseases. So the average office worker can actually sit for 13 to 15 hours a day. And I found this amazing when I read this. But if you consider the time it takes you to drive to work, you're sitting. Then you go to work and you sit at a desk. And then you come home sitting in your car. You go to the couch to take a break because you've been working all day. So you can actually rack up quite a few hours of sitting during the day. So we want to fight that. We want to be in an active fight against gravity. And any exercise will actually do, any type of exercise or movement. But weight bearing will be your best because it's beneficial to just about all groups of fitness, as is yoga. And if you can stand for longer periods of time, you'll greatly facilitate your ability to replicate ancestral movement patterns. And the reason we want to do that is because our bones are getting thinner. About 12,000 years ago, humans started pursuing agriculture. And at just about that time, our bones started getting thinner because we were moving out of the hunter-gatherer, foraging type life that we were leading, and we were moving on to agriculture and settling down. And so, you know, those low bone density isn't the only problem that comes with sitting. There's so many other problems, like your blood sugars go up when you sit, your cholesterol, blood pressure, toxins that build up in your body. So you need to get up. That's what the big message here is today, that I care about you. You matter, and I want you to get moving. It's springtime, and the sun always shines at BPTV. So whether it's shining outside or not, we've got it here. And, you know, just move. That's my message today. So when you sit for prolonged periods of time, hours and hours, and you get up, a cascade of things happen in your body. Systems start to activate. The systems that involve your blood pressure, your cholesterol, your triglycerides, your blood sugar, all that starts to activate. But when you're sitting, it's not, because when you sit for prolonged periods of time, on a molecular level, you're telling your body that to shut down, that you're getting ready to die. And that's why all of these numbers start to go up, because we were made to move all day long. And that's just how our bodies were designed. So they found out in some studies that adults who sat longer than 11 hours per day have a 40% greater chance of having problems than people that get up. You know, so, and you actually have a greater risk of dying within 3 years compared to people who set less than 4 hours a day. Over 11 hours, that's bad. Less than four is good. So as a consequence of sitting, remember, all the bad stuff, all those points are going to go up, the cholesterol, triglycerides. So we have to find ways in our daily life how to actually stand and get up, because we live in a world where we're on the couch, we're in a desk chair, and we're driving to and from places. So, got your shoes on, got your water, let's get busy. Okay, are you with me here? March it out. First thing we're going to address is cardio. And you want to do it in that order. Inhale up, start with cardio. Exhale out, really reach. Inhale, exhale, inhale up, exhale out, side to side. Now, we're going to do some easy things today. We're just going to move. That's all I want you to do, is just stand up, get off the couch. I see you're still sitting there. Come on, join me here. Let's just move. Now, you're home, so you don't have to worry. I'm on TV. You can actually do whatever you want at home. You might have some kind of funky move you like to do, so just do it and get moving. Let's start to add the shoulders. Ah, looking good. And we're just moving. Breathe. Now, while you're moving and all of the components of fitness, I want you to think about standing tall, your posture. It's really important. Now let's make this a little bigger. Add a little squat and reach. Remember the swim. I have to tell you something. It's really funny while we're moving. Something that happened to me the other day. I was in the doctor's office. Keep moving. I was in the doctor's office. I was reading a magazine on fitness tips for 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, and beyond. I'm in the beyond class, and I kind of took offense at that, because what are we beyond? Fitness is for life. I don't care how old you are. I'm in my 60s. You got to work out. You've got to do the weight bearing, and standing is weight bearing, and that's the most important. Just get up. We're going to add an alternating knee, and I'll show you, it looks like this. Lift. And we're just lifting. We're going to add some arms. Now suck the stomach in right here. Stand tall. I don't want you folding over. We're standing tall. Inhale, exhale. If this move is too much for you, I just want you to move. I don't really care too much what you're doing right now. Just as long as you're moving. Breathe. Start to make the moves bigger. So this will be your formula. Cardio. Always start first, warming up. March it out. Walk it forward. Bring it to me. Tap. Take it back. Tap. Pump those arms. Stand tall, suck that stomach in. Put the shoulders back. Let's warm up chest and back. Push it out. Two, three, and tap. One, two, three, tap. Bring it to me. Two, three, tap. Back to side, take it here. And just move those arms. So this is simple, and the reason we do cardio first is because you need to warm up the muscles before you use them. A lot of times, I'll see people stretching before they work out. We're going to alternate hamstring curls, and it looks like this. Curl. Using the back of the arms, using the back of the legs. And that's all it is. Keep your elbows in. close to the body, and breathe. Stand tall, remember that posture. Looking good. We're gonna do a little move. It's called a grapevine. And all it is a 1, 2, 3 tap, and we'll take it side to side tap. Here we go, we take it. 2, 3, tap. Tap. A lot of things you can do with this move. But what I'm trying to stress today is it's not complicated moves that I'm asking you to do. It's just to get your body moving, because if you stretch before you do cardio, you can actually pull a muscle, because your muscles are like rubber bands. Okay, grab your weights. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is put one foot back. Now I want you to get your hips in line with the wall in front of you. Grab your weights. Shoulder blades are together and slid down. We're gonna start with split squats. Looks like this. Inhale, exhale. Stay with me on this. If you don't have any weights, that's okay. You don't need them. If you do have weights, you're not choking the weights. It's an easy grip. 8 more. 1, 2, I missed that one. 3, 4, 5. Now look at my shoulders, they're back. 2 more. Okay, bring it up. Let's take it to the other side. Line it up, get ready, set, here we go. We'll take it down. Shoulder blades are engaged. Shoulders are back, stomach's in, you're tall. Again, make sure that front knee is over the ankle. It's not in front of your toes. This is really important. Breathe. Woo, I can feel it. 4 more. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Bring it up. Now what I want to tell you, I have a chair here. If you need your chair for balance, make sure you just hold on to that. And I'm going to put my weights down for a sec. And we're going to come here and kick back. And kick it back. Squeeze that butt. Breathe. Exhale on the hard part. Inhale when you come down. Looking good. 4 more. Squeezing that butt. And hold it here. And curl. 2, 3. Use your chair. 4. And you can just touch it lightly. 5, 7. One more time. Looks good. We're going to do it on the other side. Same thing. Take that foot back and curl it up. Notice I'm flexing my foot. I can engage my hamstring a little better that way. Again. And one set of straight leg kickbacks. Take it. 1, 2, 3. Looking good. Exhale back. Seven, one more time, and 8. Now come to the front, get your weights again. Here comes the big boy of leg exercises, the squat. Here we go, down. Now when you squat, look at my knees, behind my toes. I'm not out here. Sit back like you're trying to sit in a chair. Inhale. This is the king of leg workout. I want you to do these right. Come down, come up, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Inhale down, exhale up, inhale down, up, inhale. Ooh, we're gonna be squatting here, so keep it going. This is the grand finale on the leg workout. Squeeze that butt. Bring the feet close together. Down, squeeze it. Breathe. Posture. light grip on the weights. Now we're going to slow it down. Two down, two up. Breathe, two down, and breathe on the way up. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale, keep going. Breathe, almost there. Looks good. Inhale down, exhale up. Let's go wide, down, wide. Inhale, exhale. You can put the weights here and breathe. Just make sure you keep your shoulders back. You can add a little bit to this. You can come up, squeeze. Squeeze in the back. Breathe. Shoulder width, down for two. Up for two. Breathe. Keep your form. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. We're working on the strength component of fitness right now. Keep with me here. Get up off that couch. I see you sitting. Okay, good job. Upper body. Keep your weight. One arm at a time, bicep curls. Breathe and bring it down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Breathe. When you get that weight up there, turn it just slightly, like you're turning your pinky finger in towards your armpit. Looking good. Breathe. Up for two, both arms. Exhale up. I need you to stand really tall now. Sometimes the weights will pull you forward. You don't want that. Posture. Four more. Don't lean. Get off that couch. I see you trying to sit down again. Come on. We're moving. We're almost there. Looks good. Out here. Bring it down. One at a time. Exhale. Pretend you're pouring out a drink at the top and bring it down. Exhale, pouring out a drink. You're gonna feel that in those rear deltoids. Two up, two down, both arms, here we go. Up, down, up, looking good. Breathe. I'm sucking my stomach in. I'm standing really tall. I'm breathing, not holding my breath. Exhale, inhale. Last two, breathe, and take it up, pour that drink out, and bring it back down. Flat back, this is called a duck butt. Put your butt out, bring your elbows up, keep your head in line with your spine, take it back, bring it forward, take it back, and exhale. Keep your hands a little bit loose on the weights. Exhale. Try to keep looking at the floor. Don't look like this, because you're going to crimp your neck. If you have to look at the TV, look sideways. Just get sideways, suck your stomach in. Back is really flat. Four more. One. Two. Breathe. Three. Anybody else sweating? And four. Good job. Hold your weights up. We're going to put these moves together. Lower and upper body. We're going to start with the upper body shoulder press. Looks like this. Ready, set, up and down. Push up and down. Push up and down. One more time. Breathe. Now do a squat. Three more squats. Your weights are here. I'm going to show you a couple different ways to do this move. When you do combination moves, upper and lower body, burns a lot more calories. Here we go. We're going to go down. Come up, push up, come down. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now remember, you can do just half of this workout. You can do the lower body or the upper body, or you can put them together. I'm going to show you the advanced move for the squat and shoulder press. You don't have to go here, but it looks like this. Squat, push up, come up, down, woo, down. One more. Looks good, bring it down. Hammer curls. Palms are facing your sides. Looking good. Turn sideways. Breathe. Both at the same time. Up, add a leg. Up, and up. Wow. It's time to stretch already. I can't believe it. Put your weights down. So we did cardio, strength, flexibility. Use your chair if you need to. We're gonna step wide. Bring your arms out. Turn your foot in. Turn the opposite foot straight out. Gaze over your arms. Try to get your arms parallel to the floor. Reach up on the inhale. As you're reaching up, you're reaching down. You're building and stretching, building opposition in the stretch. And then as you exhale, you can hold on to your chair if you need to. Warrior pose. Stomach's in, shoulder blades are engaged. You want to take this a little further. Today we're just going to put your elbow here, open your hand, take your palm away on your back, and then open the chest and breathe. Ah, feels good. And let's come up to center. Legs are still wide. Take a big inhale. Exhale. Fold forward. Put your hands on your knees and just come forward and let your back stretch. And then pull your stomach in and roll it all the way back up. We turn this foot out. This foot comes in at about a 15-degree angle. Arms are up and reach. As you inhale, remember you can always use your chair. That's why it's here. Inhale up, reach up, and reach down. Stretching. And then bend that front knee. Remember the front knee, you might have to step out. You want it to be right over that ankle. Oh, this feels good. Inhale up. If you want to go a little further, just bring that elbow here. Palm faces away on your back and open the chest. And bring it up to standing. Let's take the hands behind the back and lift up. When you're stretching like this, you're making all those toxins leave your body. You're standing. You're lowering your cholesterol. You're doing a lot of good things for your body. So let's take a big inhale. Really reach. And reach. And reach. Lift the toe. And reach. And it's just easy. Now this is what I want you to do at home. Use these four components of fitness. And just move any way that feels good for you. Put some dance music on and stretch. Let's come to the chair. Put one foot back and stretch out that calf. You're stretching all the way down. You have that heel down on the floor. And just feel the stretch. Enjoy that for a moment. And here's where the men's tie or a yoga strap come in. If you can't reach your leg like this to pull it back, you want your knee to be pointed to the floor. It's not out here. It's good posture. But if you can't reach that, you'll just put a men's tie right there. It's really easy. Good job. Let's take it to the other side. You're stretching out the opposite calf. So just take it back. And remember, your heel's down on the floor. You want to push it down. And just, you'll feel that all the way down your calf and the back. And either get your tie or your yoga strap. You want to bring your heel towards your butt. It might not come up there, it might only come here. Don't force it because your quad muscle could be really tight, especially after this winter. I sat a lot this winter. I read 20 books over this winter. I tried to do a lot of my reading on my stationary bike, but sometimes that just, it just doesn't work. You can't bike all day long, but take a big inhale. And just reach and push up. I want you to feel as tall as you can possibly feel. And then exhale, point the thumbs down, and take those hands back. Shake it out. Bring your hands up, lift the elbows. Thank you for joining me today. This has been a lot of fun for me. I love springtime and all the flowers and everything that come with spring. It's my favorite time of year, and I wanted to share that with you today. So my main message to you is, I care about you. You really matter. I want you to get up and do this for 20 minutes a day. 20 minutes of cardio, just marching. Do some weights, upper body, lower body, stretch, balance. Find your posture, and let's just stand on one foot as we end up today. You can use your chair. You'll notice that we used a lot of balance in our exercises, but as an additional test, stand on one foot, have your posture, other foot comes up. So remember, keep moving and take the challenge and commit to be fit.